Hey there, YouTubers, your boy Lippet out here with another reaction video. Today we got Pop Smoke, NPR. Let's get right into it, shall we? Hit it. Right. Let's go, that energy. This is a melody. I need that money that. I already know from like just the start that energy is going to be, you know, it's going to be insane, but. You also know this is going to be, like, it's his earlier song in his career, so you know this is more close to his roots than his other songs. So this is going to be interesting to see what he was talking about way back when. So yeah, let's get right into it. I'm excited. I need that money that buy respect. 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 I need that money. I need that money that buy respect. I need that money that buy respect. Wait. It's big on that 2 MLBOA TQ. You got it, gonna get a hunch. This is the hood Pop Smoke. Oh, this is the OG Pop Smoke. This is where he got that energy from. Got that, I need that money, that power, that respect. Ooh, let's get right into it. Come on. Get me too, me too. Flat in your body, can eagle, eagle. We make a movie like real. Teach you. No, you can't hop, I see you. See you. You ain't getting brand nigga DJ. Fuck what you talking about. Know some niggas that shoot you for nothing. Can't get this. God sure is a shoot you for nothing? I G'd you? Okay, yeah, okay, okay. But I thought for a second maybe that was an anime cover on that anime wallpaper on that phone, but hey, it's Pop, you're going a bit aggressive on this. Like, really aggressive. Been only morning, no politics and no discussions. Back at your knife, cut him. Come to my block, rush him. Been every bro, that's the sick homie. And we gon' hurt you if you trust him. Tell these big poppers standing, they see me start running, cause they know the gang and I'm reppin'. Tree shut up, Dirty Diana. Go get a breath, man, before you come get a session. What you know about fucking up Texas? Dirty the weapon, gun kicking like it's Texas. Move back, walking the party with two straps. Walking the party like who that? Say the wrong thing, we gon' shoot that. Shoot first, shoot back. It's automatic when the boost clap. Oh, you can actually see the, I mean, it's weird for me to say it because, you know, the first song I listened to from Pop Smoke was Invincible. So it's interesting to see how it's not exactly just the lyrics. It is very much the energy that's translated into that song. Like, if I had to bet it, like, Invincible would be a really good follow-up to NPR. Like, they just seem, you know, not just the same energy, they just seem to be born from each other. They're, like, very, like, yin and yang-ish, with the same kind of energy, if that makes sense. I just talk on my neck, can't prove that. Niggas say I'm a bitch, like, who that? I come in your block with, like, two nods. Everybody know I'm not too. Cut to his head if he die, woo. If you don't like me, I don't like you, woo. Has to say the 9-2 bar was just like, well, I'm just hovering over all of you. Just don't even try. I was like, okay, yeah. I mean, this is Pop when he had that swag. He knows what he wants, and he'll get it, 100%. Being I'm certified, know that I'm cool like that burner fly. I fuck with some movers and Maybachs. I fuck with some rollers and paybacks. Smooth, Vito, give two just like free throws. Pick up his shots and reload. No, we don't fuck with them people. On the block with a chopper, with just me and chopper. We're chilling with killers and scamming niggas. We know the rules of the issue and the cage of the rock. Yeah, and that's facts though, because, you know, it's very easy to say, like, you know, from the music side. It's obviously when you speak, you know, just generally on the song, yes, he would have been an incredible, successful artist. But it's also important to know that his background, you know, from crime, from theft, from scamming, it's, you know, I can't, you gotta be honest, as an honest working man, you can't respect that, but you gotta respect the hustle and the amount of effort he put in to get out of where he was. So I think it's different in a way because he's inspiring, you know, not just like, you know, one person or like countless generations across different people, different ages, that if you put, you know, your mind to matter, you can make it big. He was really about that life. He really did what he said he was about to do. He already knew he was going to be something big. And he didn't even need anyone to tell him, oh, prove it. Like, he knew if he put in his time and energy into this craft, he'd be something big. So, yeah, he killed that shit. She's out to slim a nigga. Ocean 30, yeah, I play with that steel construction. I play with that hammer, nigga. I don't
My 38 never jam, my nigga. 808. Shoot, then I get away. Then I go stay in the GLA. Silhouette. Brody got luck, but he out cause he pulling that bill away. Tell away. Knew I can't fuck you today, so you know that I tell away. Heaven gates. I'm trying to set in that heaven gates. I need that money, that bar respect. I need that money, that bar respect.
And it's odd. It's so fascinating because I love the energy from the song, but it's so much more. It's focused differently when you compare it with Invincible. Invincible is more of like, you know, it's raw energy, but it isn't necessarily directed at like the streets or at certain people or the ops. It's very much about the energy and what he wants to, you know, come with. Invincible was like a calling card. It was like a sign that says, hey, this is what I aim to be. This is what I can be. And he's looking forward. If I look at NPR, and it says Panic Part 3 Remix, not sure what it is, but just from the song, it's about him saying the energy for him to survive in the environment that he's in, he's got to be doing, you know, putting in his best. And you can feel it. It's not like he's ever relaxed in this beat. He's very tense. So I think they're very similar songs, if I had to say NPR and Invincible, but I do think there's enough differences in where he's aiming his energy towards and what the context for both songs are. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if he wrote NPR and Invincible at the same time period, but and performed them at very different times. Would not be surprised. But yeah, I think that's it. I think it just goes into chorus.
I need that money, that power respect. I need that money, that power respect. I need that money. I need that money, that power respect. I need that money, that power respect. Wait, it's big on that 2MLBOA.
TQ. And you know this is this is just how it was. This is just the, you know, when he's recording the videos of this, he's not really faking much. It really is. He really was about that life. And if I'm not wrong, there was one lyric I did catch, but I wasn't sure if I heard it right.
Cut to his head if he die, woo. If you don't like me, I don't like you. Woo. I'm 823 and I'm certified. Know that I'm cool at that burner fly.
Right. And right here, I think, you know, just the 823, I'm certified. If I'm not wrong, this is the exact same amount he told in the interview.
How many million?
Say, you know, eventually I want 823 million, you know what I'm saying?
The Apple interview, just do a reaction to it. He's like, if I had to make money, I want to make 823 million. So I think that's where the line comes from. I don't know exactly what it means. So if you guys have, you know, any more information or any more ideas, you know, just drop it in the comments. I read all the comments. So, you know, let me know what you meant by it. And yeah, that's Pop Smoke NPR. It's a conflicting song for me to react to because I enjoy the song. It's a weird feeling knowing he's not here with us anymore. And it's also the context of saying this is where he rose from. So in the bigger scheme of things, you appreciate your roots, but you also know that you have to aim for a certain direction if you want to really reach the destination you planned for. So even in the interview, when he said, when he released NPR, when he released, you know, songs that came immediately after, he knew his target audience. That was the people around him. But he knew if he had to be bigger, he had to, you know, set his sights wider. And I think Invincible was a culmination of that. It was more of a climax of what he envisioned what he could be. And to this day, I will say this. I think Invincible is probably my most listened to song on Spotify. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you beautiful bastards in the next one. Peace. Take care. But yeah, NPR is... I'm glad I did a reaction to it. NPR actually gives... It's a bit more about closure. It's a bit more about knowing who the artist was. You know. I enjoyed this. I really want... I think this was a reaction that needed to happen. Catch you beautiful bastards in the next one. Peace. Take care. Nice.